represent the Electronic Privacy Information Center. I'm the new director of the International Privacy Project at EPIC, and I also coordinator of the Public Voice Coalition, which is a group of civil society organizations who works towards the participation of the OECD ministerial meeting. Well, we would like to get engaged more policies, frameworks, guidance, or recommendations from OECD in the matters that are our concerns. For example, we work on promoting privacy policy, one of the minimum good standards, with minimum floor of privacy is the 1980 OECD privacy guidelines. So we would like that the research in other areas being held by OECD, for example, on new emerging topics like social network or behavioral targeting advertisements, which is a new topic where we would like to push more studies on data protection issues. We developed a civil society declaration. It was a joint civil society declaration with many organizations. We agree on many different topics. One of the topics are consumer protection, it's data protection and privacy, it's also digital inclusion. There are access to knowledge, avoid the extension of copyright protection, and the promotion of the public domain, and many other topics that are concerns of civil society. So we draft this and we the process was as follows. We first recollect inputs and we have a draft. We send it to some people, the drafting committees, we get back. And then as soon as we finish the drafting and more or less everybody's agreed and we get a little consensus, as always, not everybody, you know. We recollect four signatures and then we presented these documents into the internet and to the people to get signature for each organization. What we do is that we present this formal document to OECD for the secretariat and the ministers to be here us. So that's what we do. Today, Mark Rottenberg presents the summary of the declaration in the opening ceremony. We also publish the civil society background paper. I don't know if you're familiar with the OECD, but usually the OECD drafts a policy paper and a declaration. So civil society do the same. We work in a background paper, it's 42 pages, and then we work on a civil society declaration. And that's what we just finished and presented. Internet with privacy protection, where we could share and use all these networks with when the owner has the data subject or the person have the right to control one's personal information. And it's not mean that we are not going to use or enjoy these wonderful tools and technology that we believe and we like, but it's use it in a way that we could control one's personal information. So we want to use social network, but we have the right to control one's personal information. If we delete information from the website or from the social network and I delete my profile, the data will all be deleted from the social network's server. It's not that only you cannot visit it, but that the data will, our personal data be deleted. So I would like that. Completely data mining, you know, of all the personal data. Well, governments could use all this merging of different profiles from different databases in one big database and just for political or using for reasons that are not legitimate or legitimized, or they are not, there is a word, a legal word for that. Appropriate, no, it's not lawful. So, for not fair users. And for users that we don't agree to. and we even don't realize that this is happening. So the majority of people will not realize that they are doing data mining with us. OECD have, and the European countries, the government from European countries usually have very pro-privacy rules, but there is a lot of tension in the international world. We have the Asia Pacific Economic Forum, which are promoting low level, a floor, which is, it's they are developing a data protection framework, which they want to use it like the framework of privacy, international privacy. But in fact, it's really low protection compared to the 1980 OECD guidelines. Although we think that the OECD guidelines is not so good, it's a minimum floor. We need to update it. It's still much better than the APEC framework. And we have the European model, we have data protection law, which are more stronger. There are many tensions about different countries. Civil society used to protect privacy and just to encourage the control of one's personal information. But corporations, some of them, not all, well, sometimes they have problems with international data protection transfer, so there are conflicts. We are trying to solve in the international policy debate. It's complicated. Yes, we have here, we want to protect privacy, we want to get all the, to promote access to knowledge and cultural diversity, to get research, more balanced documents on new and emerging topics, on social network, behavioral targeting advertising, for example, or in consumer protection, we would like, because OECD don't develop treaties, they develop soft law, which is not binding. So these norms, the good things when you develop a soft law is that you get some political commitment. So instead to you said, for example, that you are, so these guidelines could be implemented in the national level by the governments. So if we get some progressive recommendations or suggestions on these topics, it's more easy for us that this became a law in the national law, in the national legislation. So, for example, the 1980 guidelines, OECD privacy guidelines, was implemented in many countries, all over the world, in the OECD countries. So it's more easy than us going to each government and ask them to pass a law, a data protection law. That's the whole topic about why we are here and why we are trying to incorporate our positions into the that the government hear us, because we could be here, but not necessarily the government will hear us. So we are trying that they hear us. Open, yes, open with the citizens have the power to still communicating in a free, open manner that we could have control of one's personal information, that we could create using all these wonderful tools in a creativity way without having problems with copyright provisions or from infringements of copyright provisions. That's all, I don't know.